From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Roughly 100 homeowners in Wells could defer paying their property taxes if a new ordinance passes. The proposal would allow qualifying homeowners to postpone paying their property taxes until they sell their house or pass it on to an heir when they pass away. To qualify, homeowners must be at least 70 years old and have lived in their home for 10 years. They also have to meet certain income requirements, but the program does not come without a cost.
There will be an interest on this program, interest rate, the going rate at this time, plus a half a point for us to cover our administrative cost.
And now nearly 300 homeowners could qualify. An ordinance committee is still working on the draft of the law, which could be up for a vote as early as this November. The American Red Cross is putting out an urgent call today for people who live in northern New England. The organization says they need blood donations desperately. Red Cross officials say they've had a difficult time recruiting enough blood donors this summer to meet the needs of hospitals and their patients. All blood types are needed, but they especially need type O negative. That's because type O can be given to patients with any blood type and is often given to trauma victims. The Red Cross says one person's blood donation can help save up to three lives. Sniffing out alcohol is the purpose of a new tool that law enforcement officials with the York County Sheriff's Department are now using. The primary purpose of the sniffer flashlight is for officers to use it on party patrols. And because the flashlight senses alcohol, it can help officers establish probable cause to tell if someone has been drinking.
This flashlight does not constitute evidence, but it's evidence gathering, because at the point that this flashlight indicates that the person has been drinking, then the officer takes over with his interrogation skills.
And the sheriff adds the flashlights are also a good tool on traffic stops. The York County Sheriff's Department has 8 of the sniffer flashlights, which they were able to purchase with grant money. A vote by Portland City Council last night has effectively put an enterprising college student out of business. For the past 2 summers, Matt Rand has operated a taxi service from his golf cart on Peaks Island. Rand offers free rides but does accept tips. The island's only other taxi service complained, saying it was unfair competition since Rand wasn't following the same strict regulations. So last night, in a close 5-3 vote, counselors changed the city's definition of for hire to include tips. That means Rand's golf cart service is subject to the same rules as any city cab service.
This is somebody who is not getting the license, who is not getting the insurance, not complying with any of the city rules, but because of a loophole is able to operate at a basically overhead of thousands and thousands of dollars less than we do.
I think the people out here would appreciate if I did fight it because they like what I'm doing, but for me it's just not, I'm just going to move on from this and get, you know, it obviously is not liked by the people in power, so I'm not going to.